All right, we're live.
You get the knives off our site, Josh. Right now, we're taking little bones out. And then we'll come back after we do that and we'll skin them. That one stubborn one right there.
Yeah,
that's
good.
Come around the wide part of the knife, keeping your index finger on the clip that you see on the knife. And the knives have clips on them when you get them. Lay it down flat, cut back, pull away, pull the good bone.
Come on, the other side. And now you're cutting the other side.
Yeah, and some of these fish you'll notice are a little dark. They didn't prep them right before they shipped them. You're mad when you got to cut away a piece of meat and throw it down the garbage disposal. They're stubborn. Come on. All right, that's that one. We'll probably do some clowning a little bit.
There are
water
in there.
All right, Vince, you going for another one? All right, here's the artist at work, folks. This might be better quality than your original video, because this is HD.
I know it. Hell yeah.
You know that?
Those videos are really old.
Huh?
Videos are old.
It looks really good on here. Sorry if I'm in your face.
No, that's all right. Go ahead. I can cut.
Wow.
We'll come back later.
Is he skinning right now?
Yeah, he's skinning right
now. All right, let me show some of this process. Looks like you use a PVC pipe on the front side of it to anchor
that.
It on the edges.
Yeah, where this leg's back flat like this against these grouper and snapper. So you leave as much meat as you can. When you cut back like that, you'll see these bones will come right back out of there like that.
Show that again on the next one. When what you did,
I'll do it again. And then you come back. And the inside bones, you cut back to the high side. Come back on the other side. Use your thumb and your knife as a pair of pliers. And you pull it right on back.
Nice. I just thought about the music in the background. You might get unmonetized on this video. So we'll have to learn about this. It's okay though. It's about to. I'll show you. You'll know when it happens. By the way, I'll show you. I'm gonna talk to Monica about it.
You can't mute it.
I think we could go through and mute it afterwards, but no. I just think going forward we need to, you know.
You want to bring these down for you, Matt?
I'm fine.
Cross skin in these?
Yeah, that's an excellent unless you want to move on to these guys.
Oh, nice. This is the operation in the back here. They got the...
Nice, man.
you got a last one on it.
What's that? All right, here they are. Look at them go. Talk through it, man.
Well, coming through this rocky, on the back of the backside, they press with your left hand, rolled up. All that's going to be trimmed away. Because they didn't gut them properly into the ship. Back side, pressure, and with your left hand, keeping that index finger up there where I tell you. That becomes the extension of the nerve, and the tip of your finger to the knife.
Nothing to go down the garbage disposal. You don't like wasting meat? You don't like
throw that money down the garbage disposal.
You don't want to leave meat on the bone?
He sent me a video one day with a filet of salmon and a filet of salmon tag in the basket.
It said Russo was on it when he finished. I thought he really cleaned that flounder. I don't expect everybody to be this fast to begin with, but they can still learn how to do it right.
Show, hey, raise it up again. I want to see, you can see through it, folks. Look at this. Look at this. That's beautiful.
You might have to trim a little of that belly off. It's a little ragged, but
I don't know where it's at. Huh? You're going back through now.
Taking the little ones up for sure. Eat it like a banana and enjoy it. Yeah, this is great.
This is awesome. Right. You want to put them on here? How many pounds are there?
Close.
All this good.
Hey, Vince, you just got a question.
What?
How often do you sharpen your knives during this?
Well, it depends on what we're cutting. If you're cutting something like flounder, you can do quite a bit. But if you're cutting big grouper, things with heavy bones, we've got to kind of chop it out. You have to just play it by feel.
He just sharpened right before you started this, though, right?
Yeah, I've sharpened my knife about 3 or 4 times this morning.
Maybe we can show
him. A dull knife will cut you more than a sharp knife.
Your website just went off. You got a new visitor from North Carolina, it looks like.
I wonder if it's really effing.
Explain what they're doing over here. Yeah. Explain it.
Turn the scale up. Turn the scale up. I'm going to show you the professional scale he's using here. Let it slow down. Looks like a ear of corn with every little kernel missing. And it, if you got a snag, it'll hit it, but it won't hurt anything. And I got one called bear claw at home, a little bit. Come back, make sure you get up behind the
scale. Wow.
Don't let it hit your fingernail, because it'll take it off.
Hey Vince, let me show that real quick. Look what he's doing. He's sharpening his knife.
Keeping it flat. The flatter you keep it, into the blade, the thinner the edge, the sharpen the knife. Don't put it on a 45 degree angle like you're doing a hatchet.
This is what you got to show people.
You're showing it now.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Walk us through it.
Take it on the tail. Take it on the edge.
Start in the back. Once you get it, get a little something to hold on to. Hold that tail. And just seesaw back and forth and pull at the same time. Keeping it flat to the skin. You're pushing down the whole time?
That skin looks like.
Hold it up so we can see through it.
You can't see through it.
Oh, wow. Kinda. Okay. I'm gonna show you guys again. Are you pushing down on the knife?
Pushing down, trying to rub and keep it on the bottom. 93 angle. You don't want to cock the knife like that. You want to leave it flat. Keep wiggling that skin and seesawing back on your blade.
That's how it's done. That's how it's
short knife here. Now he's got that longer knife, a little bit easier. This is like a 12-inch blade. The one he's got down there, sure that's right. That's a 14-inch blade. That's the one he's got on the site. And when these guys are doing all short pitches, it's a little faster. I could say it's shorter and longer.
Yeah. So this is a 12 inch.
Yeah, this is 12.
You said a 14 is on your website.
Right.
So
that's like the one he's got down there. You can do small landlocked fish with it. Uh-oh, that one there. A little piece on the back side.
Here at Russo's Seafood in Bluffton, South Carolina. I'll give you guys a real quick look at what, once he gets up and running, he's gonna have a whole retail shop going on here. He's gonna have, obviously, your tuna, your grouper, your flounder, your mahi-mahi, your red snapper. They're in right in the back, cutting fresh. This is the view out front. We're right across the street from Red Cedar Elementary School. Thinking again, English. All right, so Craig, he sharpens, I mean, I'd say I've seen him sharpen once every 45 minutes or so. This is the operation little Charlie's got over here. They got fish going out in the back right now. They got the wizard working on the fish over here. You can get all these knives at cleanyourcatch.com. Also, we'll have a link below for anything on Amazon that he has. We're live, so if you guys have any questions, leave a comment and we'll try to answer it right now. We got 13 people live, man.
Thank Oh, really? Good. Good morning. It's a good afternoon. We've been cutting some 6:15. My cameraman was late, guys. We'd have to go earlier. He had to go.
I was up early. What are you talking about? I had other things to do.
Yeah, I think the bathroom, we're back to bed. We're going to bust each other's chops, guys. We aren't going to cut anybody in the slack.
How much are they paying you to do this, man? So Vince charges about $400 an hour if you want him to come clean fish at your place. It's a minimum 2 hours plus we need to incidentals and stuff, so it's about $1,000. Vince will come clean fish at your house for 2 hours. He'll show you how to. Hey, he'll show you how to do it. $1,000. 2 hours of Vince coming and showing you.
Hey, we did get a contract last year.
He said, Craig says, did he use any of the bottle cap skinning tools here?
No. But I use them at home. I don't usually catch fish this big on average. I will show you that again. Apparently, he's watched that stuff before, right?
Yeah.
Who was his name?
Yeah. Craig. His name's Craig.
Hi, Craig.
He's the one that asked about the knives. How many times you sharpen your knives while you're cleaning?
Oh, yeah. And you can see, depends on the fish. If you're doing trout, things like that, with smaller, not as heavy of bones, you don't have to do it as often.
John Collins, he said, don't just do it right.
That's right. Nike just wants to do it. And you know how Nike does. That's why I don't watch pro football anymore.
What are you doing with them now?
He just likes to keep it.
It's a lot of meat right there.
That's a beautiful stuff. You can see all the work it takes to get there, so you can go buy it. And remember, when you go home and come like a steak, you got that load of bristles you're throwing away on the steak, and you can get it over and put it back. The next best buy is for a pound of fish rather.
You don't have any what? Oh, yeah. You got anything else you want to say? Do you want to talk about, you don't want to talk about his shop or anything? Okay. We got delivery guys coming in the back. Well,
he's picking up an oil.
Oh, he's picking up an oil. Well, we got, if he's back there, we'll go grab him for, like, say, hey, we, if he's got a minute. If he does, if not, no big deal. Just to walk through every. Hey man, do you want
to
walk the people through real quick?
I'd love to.
So this is the man right here.
First of all, welcome. Russo Seafood Bluffton. So the plan is, my forte all this time was continue to do wholesale and then bring the people of Bluffton, South Carolina, a great retail setup, much like my grandfather did in Savannah, Georgia. What you can see is our fresh forte is our deal. So we have a small freezer. We'll have packaged portion fillets of all kinds of fish. We'll have shrimp, scallops, clams, oysters, mussels, you name it, we'll have it. This came off the big back of a sport fishing boat. Yeah. We did it and repurposed it as our countertop, kind of fits the groove.
That's awesome, man.
We'll do Uncle Vincent, who we met. He and I put all these boxes on the walls here. These are old calibre boxes from the Gulf of Maine. And we use all these to put our dry goods on here. Anything from salt and pepper, Old Bay seasoning, cocktail sauces, tartar sauces, horseradish, anything that goes on all the seafood. The plan in the future is to have two lemon and a lime tree outside.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Buy some fresh seafood here. You can pick a lemon or a lime off the tree.
That's awesome.
All these racks will be repurposed. They all came from Pier 1 when they shut down. So we'll also put dried goods on all these. All this here, we put this counter in. And these beautiful boxes here, unrefrigerated, we'll fill them up with ice every morning. This will get fresh whole fish cut to order. Customer comes up, puts it on the scale. We ask them how they cut it. We can fillet it, cut it basically any way they want. It'll go through the windows, goes to the scalers, to the cutters, back to the wrapping machine, and back out. Meanwhile, we'll have the customer kind of milling around, picking out stuff to go with whatever they may buy. Over here you see a couple of old looking pieces of antique, if you will, counters or bookshelves. We'll have plenty of books of any kind, seafood recipes, Uncle Vincent's cookbook over here. We'll have every kind of tradition that the Russos have ever had in here, just in a little bit different city. And so yeah, that's what we got. All these counters are made out of old houses that they had ripped down in Savannah, Georgia. So we brought a little Savannah over here. But anyway, my motto is just, if it works, use it. Great Pa had a great thing going over there in, on 40th Street from 31st to 40th in the 70s, and now to Bluffton in 2020. So,
nice.
Yeah, come visit us. Come pick up some of his knives, cookbooks. We got anything that can be invented will be invented by him.
When do you think, what do you estimate the opening date?
We're pushing hard for the end of November. I'd like to be open for the holidays so we can bring that jazz to all the people around here. That's if we can make it work. So
and say the address again. I don't know.
246 Red Cedar, Bluffton.
Okay.
So anybody traveling to and fro Hilton Head can call pre-order. You can pick it up on the way before your stay. You can pack it up to go when you head on home. We'll have it in the cooler, iced and ready for you. And that's a no-leak cooler, so you can put it in the back of anybody's cars and don't have to worry about getting stinky.
Awesome.
Or your second option would be call in, place a pre-order for FedEx pickup, and by the time you get home from Hilton Head, depending on how long you got, it'll be sitting on your front doorstep waiting on you.
And this is a phone number, right?
Yes, sir. 843-837-7000.
That's awesome.
Come see us when you can.
Hey, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
All right, we're going to end this. Thanks for your time. Thanks, guys, for watching. Leave your comments down below. Please like. Please hit the like button. Please subscribe. All the links will be down below. And, yeah, thanks for watching.